Embattled New York Mayor Bill de Blasio has called for a halt to weeks of protests against the police brutality and racism in the wake of killing of two policemen in the city. De Blasio has urged New Yorkers to stop the demonstrations until after the funerals of the two police officers shot in Brooklyn. He also called for related political gatherings to be temporarily halted. The officers were both shot in the head on Saturday while on patrol in their car. The African-American man who killed them had made remarks about retaliation for the killings of unarmed people of color by white police officers. After the incident, police departments and unions went on alert across the United States, and police officers have been ordered to wear bulletproof vests. New York City police say they have received several threats since the shootings. Let's speak to Penny Hess. She's the chairwoman of African People Solidarity Committee, and she joins us via Skype from Petersburg, Florida. Many thanks for joining us here on Press TV, Ms. Hess. Now, first of all, what do you make of Mayor de Blasio's remarks regarding canceling these protests? Do you think it's a concerted effort to block the momentum of this protest movement?
Yes, it definitely is an effort to crush the righteous struggle of African people in this country who live under colonialism, just as oppressed people do any place in the world. And the call for the police to wear bulletproof vests, well, it's black people, it's African people in this country who need bulletproof vests. There's a statistic that an African man is killed every 28 hours in this country by the police. This has been going on for a long time. We have a prison system, the largest prison system in the world, 2.3 million people. The vast majority, two-thirds of the people in prison are African, Mexican, indigenous people. It is a colonial prison system. The African community here lives under very serious colonial conditions and colonial terror every day. New York City, where the police killings happened, in that city, in 1 year alone, 850,000 black and Latino young men were stopped and frisked by the police there. There is constant harassment. We live in a country where there is colonialism, just like the Palestinians live under. So the black community and Mexican community lives under here in the United States. This is the reality of a country built on slavery, built on the genocide against the indigenous people and the theft of the land. I'm part of the Solidarity Committee under the leadership of the African People's Socialist Party. We work in the white communities to win other white people to take a stand in solidarity with the right of African people to liberation and for reparations to African people. We have to recognize there's two Americas. White people have 22 times the wealth of the black community. We don't have to worry about our children, our sons, going to school and being shot down by the police or terrorized even in these schools. We don't have to worry about them being out at a graduation party and being shot down, just like here in St. Petersburg, a 17-year-old was killed at a graduation party, shot in the back by the police. We see the police getting away with this with impunity, because we do have two Americas. We have colonialism here. And that I also want to say that from the African People Solidarity Committee, we stand in solidarity with the right of the black community to have the Black People's Grand Jury, which is going to be January 3rd and 4th in Ferguson, Missouri, and also to call for black community control of the police. There has to be the ability of the African community to control their own lives, their resources, and to unite as African people all around the world. I want to see a future in which all humanity can live. I don't want to see black people shot down in my name, just as I don't want to see the U.S. droning and bombing people in the Middle East, Africa, or other places in the world. I want to be part of humanity.
Indeed. Now, Ms. Hess, let me just come in here. Wouldn't it be more prudent for authorities, specifically elected officials in the U.S., to get to the root of the matter, to deal with this systematic racism that we're seeing within institutions of the government, and also to curb police brutality rather than to try and put off these protests?
Well, I mean, I think that, of course, but I do want to say that the question is deeper than racism, because it is not just the ideas in somebody's heads. It is a political and economic system that's built at the expense of other people. In other words, they call it white power, you know, because the white community and white people live in different conditions than African people do here. So that it is colonialism here, and that has to be recognized. And there is a legitimate struggle of colonized peoples to struggle for their own state power and control over their lives. And that is really what we're seeing here. Because when the police are targeted, those are the symbols of state power, the colonial state power that intervenes as a military force inside the black community every single day. We have to understand this.
Right.
People are living under conditions of terror and fear and trepidation just to live their lives. This happens here. We're not talking just about what happens in the Middle East, but everything, all the kinds of war, militarized police forces, helicopters, tanks, all of those things that we see in U.S. war zones that are acknowledged war zones around the world, we see here inside of black communities.
And
we see it every day. So that is the question. This is a system built at the expense of African and oppressed peoples around the world. And I am an anti-imperialist. This imperialism must go.
Okay, I'm going to have to stop you there, Ms. Hess. I'm afraid we've run out of time. That was Penny Hess, the chairwoman of African People's Solidarity Committee, joining us via Skype from St. Petersburg, Florida. Many thanks indeed for your comments here on Press TV, ma'am.